Good afternoon and welcome to RJ1200 and TrevorMcManus.com. Tim Dickert, Trev McManus, we are the news guys. You can catch us weekly Saturday mornings from 9 to 10 a.m. RJ1200 on your dial. You can also catch Tim Dickert. You're doing the morning show stuff?
Morning shows, yeah, Paris and Charania.
6 to 10 in the morning, Monday to Friday. You can catch me on the drive home grind. That goes from 3 to 6 daily, Monday through Friday, of course. And now we want to do our weekly show, our quick podcast here, our video cast. And I want to start off on Twitter. We've got people asking us different questions about it. And rmangy26 asks, at Trev McManus, with Shane Doan having a bunch of meetings with the at Vancouver Canucks, do you think he will sign with them?
It's starting to look like it's a possibility anyways, because the word is that Jameson, the guy
Greg Jameson, yeah, the former CEO of the San Jose Sharks.
Who was going to buy the Coyotes, apparently is $20 million short.
Yeah, which to me seems a little weird, because $20 million for, say, $300 million, I feel like you could just shake that loose in a pocket somewhere.
Yeah, but isn't the asking price for the team like $150, like $150 million? Like, I think it's a low price already, and they certainly can't just knock $20 million off the price because they want to sell it. So it's looking less and less like they're going to, like, this is going to go through in time for the season to start. And in which case, I don't think Shane Doan will re-sign with the team.
Yeah, I'll handle that and say that I think Shane Doan, the fact that he's taking meetings right now, he's going to go out and he's going to say, you know what, I've spent my time, I've done my deal here, I'm done. You know, I can't handle this anymore. He's a good company guy, and with that being said, you can only take so much.
Well, he's put in his time. It's not like Phoenix could say, oh, we lost a free agent because he just went out and chasing the money. Because, number one, it's not about the money, or else he would have signed in Montreal already because they offered him a ridiculous amount of money.
Yeah, something like $30 million over 3 years.
Insane.
Insane. And Buffalo apparently offered him a $30 million deal over 4 years as well. So that's an obscene amount of money.
Yeah.
His sister lives in Kamloops still. His wife is from Kamloops. He's got family there. Does that help? I think what does help is his relationship with Lawrence Gilman. If this is false, let me know, but he is besties with Lawrence Gilman.
I think besties might be too strong a word, but they are familiar. Friendly, even.
Would they have a beer together?
They would. They'd probably have six. They'd share a six-pack, I think.
Okay, there you go. That's pretty close to besties. I just want to jump to your Twitter here, at K Cadell. He says, at young married guy, how do you feel that horse dancing is in the Summer Olympics while women's ski jumping is not in the Winter Olympics? Do you want to handle this one?
I think anything, number one, anything with dancing in its title shouldn't be in the Olympics because it's not a sport, it's dancing. Horse dancing.
A lot of people think dancing is a sport.
You can do everything, you can do anything competitively, it doesn't mean it's a sport. Just because something requires a little bit of athletic skill doesn't mean it's a sport.
And really, I mean, the horse is doing all the work, let's be honest.
It's, okay, horse dancing, beat it. But it's not even that horse dancing, it's like horse dancing's in and it shouldn't be. It's that women's ski jumping isn't in. Like, why not?
Yeah, because I think, you know, when it comes down to the Olympics, there are a lot of sports, we'll say, that questionable.
They're just in it because traditionally they've been in,
exactly,
in the Olympics. But you know, so instead of analyzing whether that should still be there, whether people want to see it, whether the competition level is high enough, they just decide it's always been there, let's just keep it and let's just move on.
You know what needs to be talked about more is anybody who goes snowshoeing or biking or swimming and then have to shoot a pistol afterwards. That is unreal because, I mean, you got your adrenaline running,
yep,
your heartbeat is still rising,
yep,
and yet you still have to shoot something, which,
yeah,
I mean, is
amazing.
Hard enough.
Yeah.
So
I'm in for that one. That can stay forever.
What if we took horse dancing and then put a pistol in there?
Sure.
Like, and we call it, say, the cowboy competition, something like that.
They have to ride around and shoot targets?
There you go.
Okay. Does that, can we have still have women ski jumping in the Winter Olympics?
Or will they be holding a pistol?
Probably just jumping.
Okay. Well, yeah, we'll talk about that one.
But maybe through flaming hoops or something like that?
Okay. So because they're women, they have to have some sort of gimmick? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, that's exactly what I'm saying.
Okay. All right. So all jokes aside, you can
send your complaints to...
for all the women... That is at Young Married Guy. I am at Trev McManus, pro women. And weekly on Saturday mornings, you can catch this big lug here. You can catch me, the news guys, on RJ1200, 9 to 10 in the morning. And, of course, our weekly cast here. For TrevMcManus.com and RJ1200.com, Tim Dickert, Trev McManus.